Okay, this is a tutorial about second order differential equations. And the one that I want to look at in particular is this one. D2x by dt squared minus 7dx by dt plus 10x equals 20t plus 6. So it's worth just noting here, I guess, x is a function of t. That means that we can, you know, dx by dt is meaningful because x is a function of t. And then we've got some initial conditions as well. We're told when t equals 0, x equals 4, and dx by dt equals 9. And we're going to solve this using the approach of the complementary function and the particular integral. And we'll talk through what all of that means. So whenever I'm talking about how to solve differential equations, the first thing that I like just to remind everyone is it's an equation, right? This is an equal sign. So what we need is to choose a function so that the left-hand side is equal to the right-hand side, gives us the right-hand side when we calculate it out. And the complementary function and particular integral approach, first of all, we notice just that if the left-hand side, if we choose a function x that gives us 0 when you put it in on the left-hand side, then we can add up a whole load of those and we'll always just get 0 on the right-hand side. And then we need one copy of the function where when we put that in on the left-hand side, we get 20t plus 6. So the complementary function is something where the left-hand side gives us 0, and the particular integral is something where the left-hand side gives us, in this case, 20t plus 6. Okay, let's start this and see how we go. Complementary function, we're seeing d2x by dt squared minus 7dx by dt plus 10x equals 0. And what we always do at this stage is to try an exponential for our for x, and that exponential is going to have the form x equals a e to the alpha t. The reason that we try that form of x is because I know when I differentiate it once and then twice, I'll still get things which have got an e to the alpha t in them. So I won't have any difficulty adding up minus 7 of them and plus 10 of them and one of them here. We'll see how that goes. So what we need to calculate now, we've got x, we need dx by dt and d2x by dt squared. Differentiate once and we get alpha a e to the alpha t. Differentiate twice and we get alpha squared a e to the alpha t. I put that in brackets because it's kind of just an aside. It gives us all the terms we want to substitute back into this equation that we started with. So we get alpha squared a e to the alpha t minus 7 alpha a e to the alpha t plus 10 a e to the alpha t equals 0. Substituting in this here, this here, and this here. That's what we've done. Now I'm going to take out, I'll notice that there's a factor of a e to the alpha t in each of these three terms, and I'll take it out. Alpha squared minus 7 alpha plus 10 a e to the alpha t equals 0. And now I'm going to use a bit of maths that says when two things multiply to give 0, one of them must equal 0. And this term here doesn't equal 0 unless capital A equals 0, which is not an important case to think about. So this term here has to equal 0. That's really the key. And we get alpha squared minus 7 alpha plus 10 equals 0. And this you'll sometimes see called the characteristic equation. And you'll sometimes see people jump straight from this setup of the complementary function straight to the characteristic equation. And you can do that if you like. I think it's kind of helpful just to include these steps to remind yourself of that all of this comes from making an assumption about the form of x, the function that we're looking for. Anyway, this then means if I factorize this quadratic, alpha minus 5, alpha minus 2 equals 0, so alpha equals 5 or alpha equals 2. And that gets me to the complementary solution. We had a form here. We said it's probably of this form, and then we found out that will be true if alpha equals 5 or alpha equals 2. Then the left-hand side here should give us 0, and we'll come back and check that in a bit. Anyway, that means the complementary solution is x equals a e to the 5t plus b e to the 2t. Just underline that to show it's a kind of final bit of this step. So that's how we get to the complementary solution. Complementary function leads to the complementary solution, but don't worry too much about the wording there. Okay, next we need to think about the particular integral. And for the particular integral, we do want that the left-hand side, when we calculate it out, gives us what's on the right-hand side. And so I guess what I want is something where when I take the function and add up some number of it, 10 of it here, and then I differentiate it and add some more of that derivative, and then differentiate again and add some more, I get something that looks like the right-hand side. And here the right-hand side is kind of a polynomial. It's a first-order polynomial. So I'm going to use that as my trial particular integral. And I'll say x equals ct plus d. So because this function here is a first order polynomial, I'm going to try making x a first order polynomial. And then just like before, we'll work out, now that we've got a trial form, we'll work out what happens when you differentiate once, differentiate twice, substitute back in, and then hopefully find what C and D must be. So if X is this, dx by dt is just C, right? When I differentiate a constant, I get 0. And when I differentiate C multiplied by t, I get C. And that means d2x by dt squared equals 0. When I differentiate a constant, I get 0. Next, I will plug all of these back in and I'll get 0 minus 7c plus 10ct plus d equals 20t plus 6. And if I just rearrange this left-hand side, I'll get 10 c t plus minus 7 c plus 10 d equals 20 t plus 6. Comparing coefficients, so this term must equal this term. 10c equals 20, so c equals 2 here. And minus 7c plus 10d equals 6. This term here must equal this term here. That's kind of the units term, I guess you could say. We know c is 2, so this is minus 14 plus 10d equals 6. And when you rearrange all of that, add 14 to both sides, you get 10d equals 20. D also equals 2. So our particular solution is x equals ct plus d, and we know c and d are both 2. So x equals 2t plus 2. And again, I'm going to underline that just to kind of show that that's an important step in our answer. The next step, remember at the start we said we find a function where the left-hand side gives us 0 when we put that function in as x. That's this function here that we've got to. Then we find a function where the left-hand side equals 20t plus 6. That's this function here. And then we say the general solution is the function that gave us 0 from the left-hand side plus the function that gave us 20t plus 6, so that when we add them all up, we get 0 plus 20t plus 6, which is 20t plus 6. So anyway, all of that means that the general solution is x equals a e to the 5t plus b e to the 2t plus 2t plus 2. I just want to maybe do a brief aside now. If we take that general solution, I'll just copy it onto here. X equals a e to the 5t plus b e to the 2t. Just make a note that this is an aside. You don't have to do this as part of your solution, but it's just helpful to remember that this is what we're really interested in. Dx by dt is 5a e to the 5t plus 2b e to the 2t plus 2. And d2x by dt squared is 25 ae to the 5t plus 4b e to the 2t plus 0. Right, now I'm going to put that into what's here on the left-hand side. And we get 25 ae to the 5t plus 4b e to the 2t minus 7 dx by dt, 5a e to the 5t plus 2b e to the 2t plus 2 plus 10x so what I've been doing there is taking this left-hand side, taking the function x that I've calculated as being my general solution, and seeing what happens when I use that on the left-hand side. Okay, I'll start multiplying out some of these brackets. We've got 25ae to the 5t plus 4be to the 2t plus minus 35 ae to the 5t minus 14 be to the 2t minus 14 plus 10 ae to the 5t plus 10 be to the 2t plus 20t plus 20. And that equals, and now what I'm going to do, if I group all these AE to the 5T terms, then what I'll get is 25 plus 10, plus 10 here is 35 minus 35. So these three terms together cancel each other out. Now if I look at BE to the 2T terms, I've got 4 plus 10 minus 14. It's 14 minus 14, and they cancel each other out. And then if I look at these three terms, I've got 20t plus 20 minus 14 is 20t plus 6, which is what I wanted to have here as my right-hand side. So in a way, all of that aside is really just to show you that the magic of maths does work here. If you take this function, differentiate it once, differentiate it twice, and plug it back into the left-hand side you started with, you get the right-hand side that you want. Okay, let's finish the question off now, because we were also told when t equals 0, x equals 4, and dx by dt equals 9. We know x equals ae to the 5t plus be to the 2t plus 2t plus 2. And at the moment, this capital A and capital B are unknowns. And that means we couldn't plot this function because we wouldn't have a value for capital A and capital B. That's what an unknown is. But we've also got two new pieces of information. So two equations, two unknowns we should be able to solve. When t equals 0, x equals 4. So I can substitute in x equals 4 there, and that equals a e to the 5 times 0 plus b e to the 2 times 0 plus 2 times 0 plus 2, which equals, this is e to the power of 0, which is 1, so that's just a. This is also e to the power of 0, which is, so this term is just b, this is 0, and plus 2. And when I rearrange all of that, I get that a plus b equals 2. Now I need to work out what dx by dt is. Dx by dt, differentiating this line here, is 5a e to the 5t plus 2b e to the 2t plus 2. I'd actually already done that calculation here. We've got dx by dt there, but that's okay. And when t equals 0, we know that 9 equals 5 a e to the 5 times 0 plus 2 b e to the 2 times 0 plus 2, which equals 5a plus 2b plus 2. And when I rearrange all of that, I'll get 5a plus 2b equals 7. If I now number these equations up, I'll call this equation 1 and this equation 2. I'll do 2 times equation 1. This is now just eliminating unknowns somehow from here. If I do 2 times equation 1 anyway, I'll get 2a plus 2b equals 4. And I already know from equation 2 that 5a plus 2b equals 7. And if I subtract there, I'll get 3a equals 3, which tells me that a equals 1. And from equation 1, a plus b equals 2. Now we know that a is 1, that means 1 plus b equals 2, which means that b also equals 1. So the solution that we're looking for is x. It's this solution here, but with our new calculations for a and b. So it's x equals 1 e to the 5t plus 1 e to the 2t plus 2t plus 2. And that is the answer. And that really is kind of the standard method for solving differential equations using the complementary function and particular integral. That kind of question, I would allocate about 20 minutes to half an hour in an exam for someone to work through all of that, I think. So try practicing answering similar questions, and good luck.